Good morning, I'm Patrick Lavery in for Eric Scott. It is Monday, October 25th, 2021. We have a powerful coastal storm that's going to come into play tonight into Tuesday. Flash flood watch has been issued for most of the state starting this evening. Chief Meteorologist Dan Zarrow with the latest at NJ1015.com. Jersey High School wrestlers, basketball players, and other indoor athletes who are breathing hard, yelling, grabbing, and sweating all over each other don't have to wear masks, but masking is required for kids who are dancing, performing a song, or acting in a play. The experts, according to our David Matthau, insist this makes perfect sense. After former President Obama visited Saturday, President Biden is due in New Jersey today. As the final push begins toward next Tuesday's election, Biden is scheduled to appear at a school in North Plainfield to tout his agenda, including universal pre-K, then onto a groundbreaking at the Kearney NJ Transit Maintenance Yard for the Gateway Project's Portal North Bridge. COVID numbers continue to be driven to new lows off the Delta variant wave that bubbled up over the summer. Statewide rate of transmission Sunday was 0.83, meaning roughly if you have six people with COVID, they are spreading the virus only now to five others. Hospitalizations are now below 825. Friday, the state passed the benchmark of 6 million people fully vaccinated. Are you wondering how the FDA and CDC arrived at the determination that you can mix and match COVID-19 booster shots? A Rutgers, New Jersey medical school professor I spoke to last week says for those who got an initial dose of Johnson & Johnson, one of the other U.S.-approved boosters could actually be your better match now. And this morning, if you go to the website for Ridgefield Public Schools, there's an alert on the front page, the district's response to an ABC7 story, a 17-year-old senior at the high school, soccer captain Mohammed Zubi, saying a teacher told him, "We don't negotiate with terrorists," when he asked a question in math class. The district suspended the staffer and notified law enforcement. They shouldn't have been fired. That, the decision of a state appeals court late last week, in the case of two Hackensack police officers, although a third, Mark Gutierrez, was ordered off the force. The city also wanted to can Rocco Duardo and Victor Vasquez, who were accused of a warrantless search back in December 2016. An update we did not want to have to give you on an already tragic story. An 18-year-old from West Caldwell who jumped onto the hood of a car to try to stop his twin brother from driving drunk over the summer has now died. Joseph Dottoli had lost a leg following that June 27th crash. Brother Anthony has been charged, and it stands to reason those charges could now be upgraded. Last month in East Windsor, we reported on a two-car crash that injured four members of the Allentown High School boys soccer team. Now the other driver that hit their car, 41-year-old Hector Esteban Palomo of Trenton, is charged with DUI and other offenses, blood tests showing he was legally drunk at the time. You can't help someone with a mental illness if you can't recognize an issue in the first place. A New Jersey group is getting a federal grant worth $625,000 over the next 5 years to expand mental health awareness training among key professions. We tell you about that this morning. Amid the whispers last week that he might leave the party entirely, West Virginia Democratic Senator Joe Manchin now seems to be in step with President Biden and Majority Leader Chuck Schumer on proposals for new taxes on billionaires and certain corporations to pay for a social services and climate change package, as discussed at Biden's home Sunday. If an agreement with SEPTA is not reached in a week, the Philly Area Transit Systems Workers Union has given leaders the authority to call a strike, and that could affect 5,000 bus drivers, cashiers, and maintenance men and women, and potentially countless other bus and train commuters just outside New Jersey. The world hasn't brought it to them, so they are hoping to recreate it themselves. Two warehouses in South Africa have been converted into experimental sterile spaces where young scientists are trying to reverse engineer the Moderna COVID-19 vaccine to mass produce it and get it to the continent's poor. The project has the backing of the World Health Organization. That's all for now from the New Jersey 101.5 Newsroom. Have a great day and make sure to like and share this video to keep the conversation going. Have a good one.